Yep, there we go.
Oh,
worked out.
Nice. Oh, floor trends. Oh, here's another one too, just in case. Got a few floor pens.
I'm prepared to clean off things like floor pens.
Yeah.
I'm not actually that prepared.
I was just saying, there's a Clorox wipe over there if you want one.
Oh, no, I'm diabetic.
Okay.
I always have all kinds of stuff with me. Spread out, everyone can
yeah,
do it.
Yeah, I was gonna say,
sense. Like,
we have a lot of bleachers too over there.
Yeah,
here.
It's outside too.
Yeah,
like, there's enough space
helps.
That you can have probably 50 people here without
yeah,
anyone really
absolutely.
Getting close. So.
I know.
I've seen three dogs so far.
Yeah.
You can have as many dogs in the fan as people.
Yeah. Say, I bet people are so dope that there's love there.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to UMass Boston. We are here at James Cotter Field today as the UMass Boston Beacons take on Plymouth State in the first round of the playoffs for the Beacons, second for Plymouth, UMB getting the bye after finishing first in the regular season. The Beacons come in 7-0, 5-0 within the conference. Plymouth State comes in at 4-4 overall, and the Panthers were 2-3 within the Little East this year. So we're just about to get ready to start on this thing. My name is Olin Hayes, and I'll be here with you as we see who goes on to the Little East Conference Finals. UMass Boston certainly the favorite today after a pretty dominant win last time these two teams played, and of course an undefeated regular season. But Plymouth, a tough team, feisty team, and in an interview this week, the coach for UMass Boston described them as well-coached and tough, and we will see if they are able to make this a little bit more competitive than it was last time. UMass Boston won the first meeting between these two by a score of 21-7. But that being said, Plymouth State was able to keep it very close for the first quarter and first part of the game. The score was only 2-1 after one, and it was really later in the third and fourth that UMB was able to pull away. And with that, we're off here in the playoffs. UMB winning the faceoff. Senior Jack Dobrzynski has been one of the stars of this team. Is an early opportunity here. The first shot of the day will go. Dara Fahey gets him on the board, and the Beacons are up 1-0. Fahey, one of the big three for this team on the offensive end. It'll be Dara Fahey along with Gavin Admirand and Conor Lenfest, who you'll see scoring the majority of UMB's points. They have, between them, all over 40 points, that's goals plus assists, on the season. And that is within just 7 games, remember. So 3 very high-scoring players on the offensive end, and certainly a lot of other players contributing as well, but those are the big three to look out for. I mentioned Dobrzynski as well. He has been fantastic in the face-off circle this year. 158 out of 229 on face-offs. And when you can control that many face-offs, you know, well over 60%, really makes it difficult for your opponents to get back into games once you've established a lead. And getting that immediate goal is exactly what UMB needed. I mentioned last time they were not able to get off to as good of a start as they wanted, but they were able to come back and dominate the second half. If they can get that big lead in the first half, you just don't have to worry about it anymore. You know, don't have to worry about being clutch in that second half. Don't have to worry as much about playoff nerves, etc. As the ball is knocked away from Fahey, but he will hold on and pick it back up. Bounce pass going to be shoveled around there. Good defensive takeaway. And the Panthers will take the ball back here, and they'll get possession for the first time today. As Bobby Delling brings it through the midfield, working against Donovan Przinski. So the Panthers will slow it down a bit here. Mike Donnelly on the near side will reset with the ball. Donnelly still moving around with it, looking for some teammates. Not a lot of open space down low. UMB letting him run around the edge a bit more. The shot saved by Meinhold. Good stop right there, and it looks like the Panthers will just barely win the race. So they will keep possession here. Looks like that is Riley Roy keeping the ball in bounds. One-on-one here, good defense. Nick Drew not able to get as much space as he would have wanted. Wraparound opportunity maybe here, but again, good defense, not giving too much room, and that one is going to sail wide. Looked like Meinhold might have gotten his foot to it, but certainly aimed wide of the net regardless. So, a little over 2 minutes played here. Beacons up 1-0, and they'll have the ball back. Christian Meinhold starting in goal for the Beacons. The freshman has emerged as the number one goalie on this team. They have 4 goalies who have played this year to varying degrees. Otto Kierleis, Christian Meinhold, Trevor Coppi, and Charlie Cook. But it is the freshman Meinhold who has emerged as the starter here in the postseason. So they trust this kid. He's been very strong this year, 735 save percentage. And we'll see if he's able to keep the Panthers in check today. 1-for-1 on shots on goal, saving shots on goal so far. And the Panthers with the ball back. Content to play this a bit on the slower side for now. IML will offload to the near side here for Liam Brown. A lot of traffic down low in front of the net. Panthers not getting much room to work with. And some good defense still from UMB. Down to 20 on the shot clock here. As Donovan Brzezinski was able to keep the near side attack at bay. Now getting down to 10 seconds to shoot. They got to make something happen here. With 5 to shoot ball still behind the net, they got to take any shot they can get here, and a quick shot will go over the shoulder of Meinhold. Panthers are on the board as it is a goal from Mark Iamelli. So that'll tie the score up 1-1. And on the Plymouth State side, definitely a reassuring sign for them to hold onto the ball for that long, not turn it over against a tough defense. And then eventually when you have to take that shot, they're able to find a good one at a moment's notice and put it in to tie up the game. So 3:45 so far played in this game. We are tied up at 1. And faceoff will be taken by the Panthers. Quick opportunity off the draw now. Low shot will go inside, and that'll be wide of the net. Panthers in position to win the race, though, so they will maintain possession. Quick break to the inside there, and a shot stick save by Meinhold. And Beacons will get it and try to go back the other way. So despite the one goal, Meinhold looking good so far. Good positioning, couple good saves. Beacons moving through the midfield. Chris Palin looking for some help, now finds it. And Lenfest will hand it off here, now on the near side, Brzezinski. Brzezinski gets it back. You can feel kind of a higher pace when UMB has the ball just across the board. Quick pass through the middle. Brzezinski's shot goes just high. Good chance at a second goal there for UMB, and Brzezinski missed by just a few inches. Brzezinski with it again. We'll give away to Murphy. Oh, and a dropped pass right there. Can the Beacons hold on to it? Doesn't look like... Oh, they do somehow. Quick low shot and a good save on the other end from the keeper, Porter. Robert Porter, starting in goal for Plymouth State, has played in all 8 of their games. He's been the starter for all the games, has not played the entirety of everything. Had a pretty good season, goals against average hovering just barely above 10. On the other side, Meinhold's is at 8.23. as that shot will come up a little bit short, and Meinhold will take it without much trouble. Low scoring start for a team who has scored quite a bit this year. UMB has had an incredible year scoring, would probably be a record-setting year if there were more games in the season. In fact, they already have broken their single-game record for goals in a game. The first game of the season, they put up 25, which was just one short of the school's record of 26. They came back the couple days later in their next game against Castleton and put up 30 to smash that record completely. So certainly a team who has put a lot of goals on the board this season. But that being said, they have often been held in check in the first quarter, more so than in the rest of the game. So could be they're just taking a moment to warm up, and we'll see if they are able to break through this Panthers defense more as we get deeper into the game. And a quick shot. Somehow that one snuck in. Looks like Mike Donnelly able to sneak that one into the net, beating Meinhold to the near side, and that is going to be a lead for the Panthers. Plymouth State going on top 2-1. Donnelly, a bit of an acrobatic play right there, and finds a way to get the ball just past the left shoulder of Meinhold into that top corner of the net. So we go back into the faceoff circle, and this should on paper be the biggest advantage anywhere on the field for UMass Boston. Jack Bonazzoli for Plymouth State coming in just a bit under 30% in the faceoff circle. Meanwhile, on the other side, is a shot there is saved by Porter. On the other side, Dobrzynski, as I mentioned, up over 60%, close to 70% on the season. And a quick takeaway and a goal right away off the turnover. Donovan Przinski puts it in. So Przinski's had a great season so far and a great start to this game, really. He's been putting on a lot of pressure on the offensive end, who just hasn't quite found the net until then. Took the shot last time they were down here and missed by just a few inches, and this time he will get his first goal of the day and tie the game up at 2. Przinski comes into this game fourth on the team in points overall, third in goals, behind just Admirand and Lenfest. Behind those same two, as well as Dara Fahey in points. As another win, face-off win for Jack Dobrzynski. Quick shot from Fahey will go just wide, might have been deflected by one of the defenders in front, and the race will be won easily by, once again, Przinski. And here we see UMB rotating the personnel a bit here, and that is one advantage the Beacons will have here. A much deeper team, much larger team, in just a raw numbers sense. Could definitely contribute to how strong they've been in the second, third, and especially third and fourth quarters this year. And a quick low shot skips along the ground. And that was a good save for Porter. So Robert Porter off to a good start, keeping his team in this game. We are all tied up at 2, more than halfway through the first period. And here comes the goalie. Nobody home. Here comes the goalie. Porter. Quick pass. And a 1v1 goal. What a play from Robert Porter. Porter not the one who scored the goal himself. That was one of the, I can't quite see the number from here, but incredible play from Robert Porter. No one was ready for that. There is no rule against that in lacrosse. There are rules about how many players you can have on each side of the field, but no rules about who those players have to be or if the goalie has to be one of them. So, very smart play from Porter. Puts the Panthers back on top, and it is 3-2. Another faceoff win for Dobrzynski. Fahey running in strong. A lot of Beacons players right around the net, but the defense will get back in time to avoid an easy opportunity. And a quick shot, great save by Porter. It was a hard shot from Murphy from the point. And Robert Porter putting on a show so far today. Panthers goalie really stepping up here in the playoffs. This is the Panthers team coming off an upset win over EastCon. They are the fifth seed, so had to beat the fourth seed to get here in the postseason. Miles Franey. Jogging around looking for some space here, working against Jack Riley. Franey over to Donnelly. Donnelly already with a goal in today's game. And a quick shot will go a little bit low and wide. Bounces off the ground around the edge of the crease. So, Panthers win the race. They'll keep possession. 30 to shoot. Sprague, the defender for UMB. Trying to keep the ball back behind the net for now. As the shot clock winds down to 20. Some more quick movement. Pass dropped right there. Can the Panthers hang on to it? They do. 10 to shoot. Got to get something off here. Long possession once again. And this time the save is made by Meinhold. And UMB will take it away. Both goaltenders playing very well so far in the early game. A couple of big saves on each side. We'll see if the Beacons can convert this one into a quick scoring chance. Ooh, and they're not going to be able to do it off that. An errant pass will give the ball back over to the Panthers. An odd man rush now. And now Plymouth State will slow it down a bit and work back into the offense we've seen from them most of the day. Good passer behind the net. Shot ripped just wide of Meinhold's cage. Small margin of error on some of these shots today. Both sides having shots that missed the post by just an inch or two. Could definitely be a little bit of a higher scoring game on both sides so far. And despite losing the lead, thanks to that heads-up play from the goalkeeper, UMB defense in these normal defense situations, very, very solid. Not giving a lot of extra space, forcing the Panthers to really work for every opportunity they get. However, the Panthers have been taking whatever they've been given. That is a dropped pass. They will hold on to it. They only have 12 to shoot. Another errant pass here. Meinholtz thinks about leaving the crease for it. And with just 5 to shoot, that'll be a turnover, and the Beacons will take it away. So, no shot there, so no race to win. Ball just goes over the end line, Beacons will take possession. Bit of an awkward pass there, but Palin able to handle it. Beacons has some good ball movement here, trying to get the ball down low, not quite finding an opening yet. Riley. Back to Lenfest. Lenfest and Riley working from the points here. Good pass to Lenfest, and a sidearm shot will go high. Looked like it might have been deflected by Porter. Beacons will keep possession. They have 35 to shoot. Looking for a wraparound here. Not quite going to find it. An errant pass once again, but the Beacons will hold on to it. Joe Myers is there. And a shot from the point deflected right away. Beacons will keep it, but only 13 to shoot now. Oh, and an over-the-back shot. Looked like it went in from here for just a moment, but it went off the side of the net, so that was why the net shook a little bit. They will get credit for a shot, though. Reset the shot clock. Not going to stop them from going aggressive, though. An immediate chance once again. Beacons keeping possession for a long time. You got to wonder how much longer Porter and the defense with the Panthers can hold up without giving anything up. Their defense has been fully in bend-but-don't-break mode so far on this possession. Been playing defense for about 2 minutes, and it might pay off, as this one is going to roll all the way to the end line and go out of bounds. So an incredible defensive sequence for the Plymouth State Panthers. And they're going to take over possession, still with a 3-2 lead. So looking similar to what we saw from these two teams last time. Low scoring first quarter. This time it is Plymouth who has the one goal lead. And still a little over 2 minutes for them to add on to it or for the Beacons to tie it up. Nick Drew. Now on the near side, once again, it's Donnelly. And that will be a shot that misses wide, so Panthers keep the ball. Just under 1 minute to shoot, just under 2 minutes to go in the quarter. Panthers leading 3-2. Missed pass right there, and it's going to roll all the way to the sideline. So Beacons will take the ball back. Shot clock just a little less than the game clock here in the first quarter, about 15-second difference. Beacons so far, other than one time, have not been holding anywhere near the edge of the shot clock, though. So don't really expect that to come into play unless they specifically play to that as a certain strategy, which we don't see from them very often. Dropped pass briefly, but able to control it still is Lenfest. Przinski over to Fahey. They have their top line back out there. Fahey, Admirand, Lenfest, and Przinski all out on the field at once. Przinski down low for Lenfest, and it goes! Or sorry, that was Admirand down in front of the goal. So that will be a tie game now with under a minute to go in the first quarter. So the score goes to 3-3 here. 59 seconds to go, first quarter. Now, can they get another faceoff win from Dobrzynski for the Beacons to try to set up one more scoring chance? And Dobrzynski takes it easily. No battle for that one. Dobrzynski just grabs it right away. So Beacons trying to get the lead back. Physical defense there. It works out for the Panthers, and they'll get a chance here with 35 seconds to play in the quarter. Game tied up at 3. A lot of space in the middle here. And a good save by Meinholtz. And the quick shot means the Beacons might have a chance to go back the other way as well. 25 seconds now in the first quarter. Murphy gets it past the midline. 15 to go. Admirand. Down low for Lenfest. Pass gets deflected in the middle. Beacons will keep it. 6 to play in the quarter. Shot misses wide. Clock is stopped with 3.5 to go. Can the Beacons make something happen here? 3.5 seconds to play. It'll be Przinski with the ball. Quick pass. They gotta get a shot off right away, and they will not. Good defense on the other end from Kieran Mahler, and that will be it for the first quarter. So, tightly contested first quarter there on both sides. Score is 3-3 through 1. We've played 15 minutes. We'll play 45 more. And we'll see if the Beacons can advance as expected or if the Panthers will be able to make the upset today and head on to the finals. We'll be back in just a minute for the second quarter. All right, welcome back, everyone, here to James Cotter Field. I'm Olin Hayes, and we're here with you for the second quarter as we almost have a goal right off the opening faceoff. Dobrzynski wins another draw. So for anyone just joining us, 3-3 in the first quarter. Beacons struck first. Panthers went back up 2-1 and then 3-2. Beacons tied it up on a late acrobatic goal from Admirand. A couple opportunities on both sides that were wasted by missed shots, and even more opportunities that were stopped by some good saves. Both goalies playing very well so far, and we'll see if that keeps up here into the second quarter or if the offenses will pick up and start rolling. Quick shot, and the first impression of the second quarter is the goaltenders will remain on top, as that's a good save from Porter off the shot from Przinski. Immediate takeaway. Beacons take the ball back, Przinski with it. Ooh, looking for Fahey or Admirand. Ball went right between them. They will hold on to it, though. Fahey gets back. Now Claflin on the near side. Good pass, and then it is thrown in once again by Lenfest. It's had such a strong year for this team. 7 goals last time out, and Conor Lenfest does it again.
That's Admirand. I think it was number 8.
So back into the face-off circle here, and Dobrzynski has only lost one all day so far. And it can be forgotten when there are long sequences without goals. But the face-off men are really so vital to whoever can get momentum and keep momentum in this game. Because if you have possession after every single goal is scored on both sides, there's only so much your opponents can really do. They have to outplay you so significantly on both sides of the ball to keep any sort of advantage. And that's the advantage that Dobrzynski gives this Beacons team. And a quick over-the-shoulder shot. Nice jumping play there from Porter to make sure the ball is not taken away by an attacker. Porter moving into the offensive end once again. They called off sides, but the Beacons miss an empty net. Beacons get possession right back, though. Fahey, low skip shot, diving block from Porter. Getting his body in front of that one. Dropped pass, but the Beacons should hold on to the ball. Brzezinski goes back to get it. Chance down low here. Brzezinski now out near the point. And the pass will get by Lenfest. And it'll be taken away by the Panthers. Whitlock out into the game now. Over to Admirand. And that shot's going to be deflected off of the traffic in front of the net. Ball will stay with UMass Boston. So we've played a little over 3 minutes here in this second quarter, and the Beacons have only scored once, but have dominated time of possession. Plymouth State has only had it twice, for very, very brief moments in time. And they've turned the ball over both times pretty quickly. And too many men on the field penalty, not one of the more common things you'll see. But it will give a power play over to UMass Boston here. The penalty is called against Mitchell Prive, Jr. So, miscommunication costing Plymouth State. We'll see if the Beacons can convert on the man-up situation. Early chance on the power play. Taken away on a good save by Meinholz. And we'll see if the Panthers can maintain possession for a bit, try to kill off this penalty for longer. Alright, so they kill off the man advantage. Still only a one-goal game, and Plymouth State with the ball, a chance to tie things up. Plymouth State again taking things on the slower side compared to what we see on the Beacons offense. The exception to that all day has been Donnelly, and he continues to try to speed his way in near the net here. Saves that ball from going out of bounds. And the ball will eventually go over the end line. Beacons will take possession back. And it looks like we'll get our first timeout of the game here. So 10:34 to go in the first half. UMass Boston on top, 4-3, a tightly contested game. Lower scoring than we've become accustomed to for the UMass Boston Beacons. Plymouth State keeping it close on defense, but hasn't quite found the rhythm on offense yet. So the score remains 4-3 in favor of the Beacons. right, just about to come out of the timeout here. Panthers will have possession. They did call the timeout before they lost the ball out of bounds. So they'll keep it here. 29 on the shot clock. And they have been looking for a lot of these wraparound chances and haven't found much success so far. Good pass there to the point, though, and a sidearm shot will be saved by Meinhold cleanly as he catches it without giving up a rebound. Good pass up there to Sprague. Sprague with some space. Usually a defensive player is going to take a shot for himself, and that was going to be gathered by Porter. So Sprague getting involved in the offensive end. Some contact in front. Shot here in front, and that'll be a goal. Game tied up once again, 4-4. As Mark Hersham gets one on the board. So we have once again a tie game. There has not been a differential of more than one so far. Every chance we've had to be tied, it has been tied. So a very tight game. Plymouth State certainly keeping things close. And now back into the faceoff circle where Dobrzynski has dominated so far today. Dobrzynski grabs another one, had it knocked away for a moment, but the Beacons are able to claim it anyway. Good pass, Fahey, another good pass over to Lenfest, and that was deflected high and wide. Beacons will keep possession. At a certain point, you have to wonder if they will switch up to another faceoff taker on the Panthers' side. Dobrzynski, again, has only lost one so far, and that is in 10 contests, 8 after the goals and 2 at the start of the periods. Ball goes loose for just a moment. Grabbed back by Claflin. Fahey, now Lenfest has it. Claflin on the other side for Fahey. Claflin working on the defenders here. 30 to shoot. Good defense so far from Plymouth State. Great pass to Claflin, and he puts it in. So 5-4 now. UMass Boston goes back in front. It's been a very tight game so far. That was Zach Mann, number 29. I see him running off along with Claflin. So Mann gets one on the board. 5-4 is the score now. As I mentioned, so far, every chance we've had to be tied, the game has been tied, so we'll see if the Beacons can break that pattern, take the first 2-goal lead of the game, or if we'll get yet another tie ball game here. 8:50 to go in the first half. Another faceoff win for Dobrzynski. It is knocked out of his stick for a moment, but Beacons will take possession back once again. So the faceoff dominance continues for the Beacons, putting a ton of pressure on this Plymouth State defense, and they have been very good. But will they be good enough to maintain any sort of close game when they're losing possession after every single goal? Well, that'll help them out for now, as an errant pass goes wide of everyone, and it'll be taken away by Plymouth State. The keeper, Porter, has already been known to bring the ball up the field himself, and he'll do it once again here. Almost gave up a goal for it last time, but the time before it led directly to a goal for his team as he got an assist on the board. On the near side, Iamelli going in towards the middle. Shot goes well over the net there, and Panthers will keep possession. Quick chance on the wraparound. Great defense. Knocks the ball loose as it was supposed to be shot. And the Beacons will take... Oh, they'll try to take the loose ball. Good play from Murphy to stay with that one after he couldn't pick it up cleanly initially. So Beacons will transition to the offensive end now. Quick pass over to Zach Mann.
Yes, sir.
Down low, and that one goes in. Looked like it was Admirand again. Great passing on that sequence for the Beacons. As Admirand gets another one on the board, and we have our first two-goal lead of the game for either side as the Beacons go up 6-4. We are just over halfway through the second period. As Joe Brzezinski sets in for another face-off. And once again, winning it instantly. There haven't even been lots of prolonged ground balls or extended skirmishes in the face-off circle. Bonazzoli has just not been able to keep up with Joe Brzezinski so far. Quick pass to Lenfest. Low shot will not quite get through. Good defense in front. And I mentioned the faceoffs. There are not a lot of people who have taken faceoffs on the Plymouth State side. The backup, according to the stats, would probably be Eric Gnome, who was 10 for 17 on the season. Obviously a good percentage, but very small sample size. And Dobrzynski has really shut out the majority of the league in the faceoff circle so far, as we get an opportunity here for Plymouth State. Great passing, and they find their mark. So the Panthers get one back to 6-5 now. And it looked like that was Riley Roy who gets that one to go. So a one-goal game once again, 6.5 to play. Not quite sure what's going on here. Looks like the goal has been called back. I'm guessing the explanation would be that the keeper, the player was in the crease. I'm not sure what else would have gone wrong there. If it was goalie interference, it would probably be a penalty. So I'm guessing that's a player stepping in the crease with the ball. Not 100% sure why that goal was disallowed. So we'll let you know if we get an explanation. Meanwhile, the Beacons on the other side. Ooh, a high pass over to Fahey, and he's able to corral it. And a good save again by Porter. So even with the Beacons taking a very slightly bigger lead, Porter having a great game. On the other side, Meinhold's looking very strong as well. Porter certainly the more offensive-minded goalie, probably the most offensive-minded goalie I've ever seen, as he tries to put one in himself, and he almost got it. His team will keep possession, though. And a hard shot from the point will go. Good passing to Riley Roy once again, and he's able to put it away. And now it is actually 6-5. So Plymouth State does grab that goal back. 5:14 to go, first half. Scoring has picked up just a little bit, but not too much. Still not far above our pace from the first quarter. It was 3-3 after one, 6-5 about two-thirds of the way through the second. Another face-off. Dobrzynski. This time a little more tied up, but looks like the Beacons are going to be able to get there first. And still no clear winner. Eventually we get a face-off win. Took about 15 seconds that time, but the Beacons are able to win the draw. Ooh. Hard collision right there between Murphy and Roy. Not something you see as often in lacrosse as you see in hockey, but it is a part of the game. And they're both still up and running. And a quick shot from far side gonna be grabbed by Porter. It looks like he's making some of these saves without moving. I mean, he really is using minimal movement to try to grab all of these, and doing a lot of work on the offensive side as well, with some good passing and of course his runs to the far side of the field himself. 4 minutes to go, second quarter. Beacons up 6-5 over the Panthers here. We're in the semifinals of the LEC playoffs. Beacons got a bye to this point as the one seed. Plymouth State an upset over Eastcon in the 5-4 matchup. So numbers 1 and 5 in the league matching up today. Good passing, a shot down low, and that one goes. Plymouth State ties it up. That one comes from Nick Drew, number 17. And the sophomore brings it back to 6-6. So 3:38 to go in the first half. All tied up once again. Has been a very, very tightly contested game the whole time.
I don't think you're allowed in here. I'll come down and say hey.
It's okay. I'm not allowed anywhere.
It's
fine.
Okay, fair enough.
So faceoff not going to Brzezinski's way initially. He might wind up with it anyway, though. Still scrambling for it in the middle. Ball squeaks out. We'll get a penalty called on somebody. And it looks like the ball will be given over to the Panthers. So it takes a tie-up and an infraction call. But eventually, Plymouth State does win a face-off, technically. Just their second of the game. And it is impressive how close they have been, despite being really just dominated in the face-off circle so far. Donnelly. He's really been the quarterback of this offense so far today. Pass goes a little bit high. Good job by Iamelli to get the end of the stick on it to bring it down. Good hit right there. Ball knocked loose. Beacons will take it away. A good catch by Riley. Got turned around by that pass, but was able to go and grab it. So the Beacon's trying to take the lead back one more time. Flag is thrown, so delayed penalty coming up here. Beacons will have a man-up opportunity as soon as they lose the ball. Admirand goes down, loses possession, and we will get the start of a power play. UMass Boston comes into the game 8-31 on the man-up situations. Plymouth State comes in at 24-34 on the defensive end. Another too many men penalty, so some communication issues for Plymouth State so far. Really the only thing holding their defense back. Their defense has been spectacular aside from a couple of ill-advised penalties that are honestly, just unnecessary. Any too many man penalties are always an unfortunate thing that shouldn't realistically happen on a regular basis. So the Beacons trying to take advantage of this power play. Lenfest with some space. And the play is whistled dead. Looks like we'll have a timeout. So we are under 2 minutes to go. 6-6, Beacons have possession. And we'll take a quick break here for this timeout. We'll be right back with you for the conclusion of the first half. Welcome back, everyone. We are here for a few more seconds of a UMass Boston power play.
Yes, sir.
And there it is. Beacons do manage to convert it, as Donovan Przinski puts it in. Looked like it was right as the power play ended, so not technically a goal on the man advantage, but Beacons will get one in nonetheless. Take the lead 7-6 with a minute 40 to go in the first half. Another face-off win for Dobrzynski. We'll see if the Beacons can grab one more here. Get a bit of an extra lead before the half. And that one does sneak in. Wow. Looked like Porter grabbed that one, but went just past him. So the Beacons do go up two once again. Looks like that one was from Murphy. So 8-6. Minute 20 to go in the first half. Shot clock essentially off. Adam Rand ties this one up. And ties it up for long enough that Cam Ford comes over to grab it. Some space for a wraparound, maybe. Good defense getting over here in time to stop that from Adamrand. Pass gets deflected. Fahey's able to grab it anyway. Inside of the last minute of the first half. Begins with a two-goal lead and possession. It's the magic of a good faceoff, man. That one ripped back to the point. And that one might have deflected off the edge of Porter's stick there, but goes a little bit wide of the net regardless. 35 seconds to go, first half. Beacons keep the ball.
Another goal would be awesome.
Quick shot, and that one's saved again by Porter. So Porter keeping his team in the game despite all the faceoff losses, despite all the extra possessions going the way of the Beacons. Long pass taken away, though. Ground ball still loose. See who can claim it. Good opportunity for the Panthers if they can win it. And they can. So 8 seconds to go. Maybe time for one more shot. Three to play. And they took way too long behind the net there. So no chance of another goal for the Panthers in this first half. But that'll do it for the first half. And two quarters in, it is UMass Boston 8 and Plymouth State 6. And it was a much tighter first half than we saw last time these two teams played. The score at the half last time was 7-2 before the Beacons completely broke the game open and ended up at 21-7. So Plymouth State looking really solid on defense, but the Beacons staying strong on offense. Good defense as well, good goalkeeping on both sides of the field. And for the Beacons, it's all about the faceoff wins. They are still dominating the faceoff circle, getting so many extra possessions. And it forces Plymouth State to be able to play defense very well in order to score consecutive goals. And it's going to be rough for them to keep doing that the whole game. Can they find a solution in the faceoff circle, or can they just step up their game to win despite that? Either way, we'll find out in a little bit, but for now we'll take a break for the halftime. We'll see you in a few minutes.
struggle. Here, though, an opening inside. Where this is a team that has to worry about the LEC tournament starting next week. Here's a drive, and this one goes for Dara Fahey, which means they're going to host first-round games. Those are going on right now, as AIC knocks the score. Part of their schedule last year, they never made it there. Season was called off. Here's another goal. This one fired in by...
Hello, everyone, and welcome back here to the second half. We have another face-off win for the Beacons already, and potentially an early offensive chance. For those of you just joining us, the Beacons are up 8-6. It was 3-3 after the first quarter. It was 6-6 part of the way through the second. Beacons able to score the final two goals of that first half. And that is where we stand now. Relatively low-scoring game. Last time these two teams played, the Beacons won 21-7. So certainly a huge improvement for Plymouth State, a team that has gotten much, much stronger in recent weeks. And to get here, they had to beat Eastern Connecticut. And now EastCon lost to the Beacons, as did everyone else in the league. But EastCon only lost by 2. They lost 10-8 in a very tight game when those two teams played earlier this year. Whereas Plymouth, as I mentioned, lost by 14, 21-7 a couple weeks ago. So, pretty big upset there. Went very much against what would have been expected. And now, not only are they in this game in the semifinals, but they have gotten very, very close to the Beacons. They have had the lead at some points in time and have kept it within 2 goals maximum throughout the game. That was a loose ball that ends up being claimed by Meinhold. There's a flag down on the field. And I believe that's going to be a delayed call that will now go, now go against Plymouth State. And that's a big penalty right there. Going to go against Mike Donnelly. 1 minute for tripping. So Donnelly has been the cornerstone of this Plymouth State offense all day. Now we'll see how they do on defense down a man. There have been 2 penalties against Plymouth State so far. Both for too many men. Beacons technically 0 for 2 on the power play, but they did score just after the expiration of the most recent one. So not a power play goal in the stats, but was realistically a conversion off of the man-up situation. And that shot is deflected. Going to be caught cleanly behind the net. Beacons will keep possession. Some good passing there, and a shot ripped into the upper corner of the net.
Attaboy.
Beacons go up by 3. Biggest lead of the game. And they will take it to 9-6 now. And a 3-goal lead, again, not a huge insurmountable lead or anything, but if they can continue to win every face-off the way they have so far, it's going to be really, really tough for Plymouth State to get back into this game. That was Fahey with the goal on that last possession. Lenfest with his 4th assist of the day. Dobrzynski did win yet another face-off, but the ball does go out of bounds and will be taken away by the Panthers here. Dobrzynski, 16 of 18 on face-offs today. Very, very good, even by his very strong standards. I mentioned hovering around 70% on the year, but for today, sitting up close to 90%. And it's really a testament to this Plymouth State defense that they've been able to keep this game close despite that many extra possessions going the way of UMass Boston. If you even keep it 50-50 in the face-off circle, that's a difference of 7 possessions already from where we are right now. So the fact that they've been able to keep this as close as they have is impressive, but they're going to have to score a little quicker and a little more frequently in order to keep this game competitive. Beacons have expanded the lead as big as it's been all night. 9-6 is their biggest lead. 3 minutes played here in the second half. 20 to shoot for Plymouth State. Shot going to be blocked in front. And good play by Sprague coming away with that ball.
He's got like some good agility.
So Sprague moving around with it for a while and then finds Murphy. Fahey. Pass deflected. Beacons possession, keeping possession.
There
Good passing still by the Beacons, looking for some open space. Murphy back to the near side. Shot deflected over the net. Good stop by Porter once again. Pass goes to no one in particular there. Beacons will just barely be able to keep it in bounds. Fahey is there to claim it before it reaches the end line. The end lines there are the blue lines. A little hard to see. That was a good butterfly stop right there. Sometimes you have to go into hockey mode in this sport as well. And a good save, once again, by Robert Porter keeping his team alive. You have to think if they get too much farther behind, it becomes a 5-6 goal kind of deficit. That's the point where it starts to feel insurmountable for a team who cannot win a faceoff so far today. But as is, 9-6, Plymouth State certainly not out of this one by any means. But this UMB defense has not been particularly lenient either. So, another errant pass right there will give the ball away, and that's the kind of mistakes they just can't afford if they want to get back into this game. Still a tight one at 9-6, but every chance the Beacons get here to go up 10-6 just increases the chances that they'll be able to steamroll this into a 7-8 goal lead before the fourth quarter.
Yes, sir. There we go. They want to see that.
So 5 minutes into the second half. Some more crisp passing from the Beacons. Murphy over to number four, Przinski. Down low for Fahey. All this ball movement, still only halfway through the shot clock. When they do lose the ball, though, good takeaway there by Porter. And here come the Panthers the other way. So Beacons get the ball back. The fast break offense not working out so well for Plymouth State. Beginning a shot from a weird angle there, somehow finds the back of the net.
Four.
Beacons get another one on the board, they go up by four, and it is Donovan Przinski who puts it in again. So Przinski grabs his hat trick. Beacons with their biggest lead once again. 4-goal lead at 10-6. And this is exactly where they want to be. Even if they're not going to be running up the score the way they did last time these two teams played, a game that ended 21-7, a 10-6 lead is definitely a lot more convincing than they've had all night. And it just doesn't feel like any sort of serious momentum can go Plymouth State's way without a change in the faceoff circle. As a shot again saved by Porter, who is doing everything he can to keep his team alive this season. Porter, senior goalie, playing in potentially his final game with the team, really doing his best to extend that by one more game. But only so much he can do as he does make yet another save. Only so much he can do when the team is not able to just get offensive possessions going. The Beacons keeping possession here, already up by four. And 5 goals to me really does feel like kind of a breaking point in this game. Passing around behind the net. Looking for some space here in front of the goal. The defense has not eased up, to their credit, for Plymouth State. Not giving the Beacons anything for free. That last goal came from a rough angle for Przinski. High pass, and the shot by Mann is saved once again by Porter. Ball goes back onto the offensive end now for the Panthers. And they haven't really increased the sense of urgency on the offensive end. Still moving very slowly, very methodical passes. And they'll wait for someone like Donnelly here to go on these little runs to try to open up some space as Donnelly takes it himself, fires just wide of the net, and Panthers will win the race and keep the ball. Still moving the ball around. It's behind the net now. Just over 30 on the shot clock. 7 to play in the third quarter. Shot from a rough angle there. It goes wide. 26 on the shot clock. Plymouth State keeps the ball. And a bit of a scramble for it on the ground there. Beacons do come out with possession. very high leap to, in an attempt to corral that one. But the ball is taken by Fahey anyway as it rolls to a stop on the near side. Beacons looking for a 5-goal lead here. Przinski. Already on a hat trick. Looking for more. He'll find Fahey on the near side. Missed pass there. Whitlock drops it, but he'll get it back. And some smoke and mirrors in front of the net. Sets up a wide open shot on the far side. And the Beacons take that 5-goal lead as the score goes to 11-6. A lot of movement in front of the goalie there. They had 3 players cross in front of the net in short succession. And then they throw the ball off to the far side where Lenfest is able to get his first goal of the day. In addition to 5 assists now. So Lenfest put up 7 goals last time out. Put up 7 goals last time these two teams played each other. Gets his first one on the board today along with 5 assists. The goals have come from 3 from Admirand, 3 from Brzezinski, 1 from Murphy, 1 from Mann, and 2 from Fahey. And now the one added on by Lenfest. On the other side, 6 players with 1. Fleury, Drew, Hirsham, Roy, Iamelli, and Donnelly. And it just seems that every time you look away from the game for 5 seconds, the Beacons have the ball on the offensive end once again. Feels like playing basketball on a local playground where the winner gets the ball instead of the loser. And you have to get that defensive stop before you even get an opportunity to play the game. And right now, it is all going against Plymouth State. Their problems really start and end in the faceoff circle, to be honest. They have not played badly on offense or defense, but it is very, very difficult to make much happen when you've won 2 of the 20 faceoffs. So, Dubrzynski has officially hit 90% on the faceoff wins today, 18 out of 20. And we've yet to see any change from Plymouth State. No backups, no other looks thrown at Dubrzynski. So, Bonazzoli, just 2 of the 20 faceoffs so far today. And that is a huge difference in this game. That pass goes a little bit past the reach on the far side of Admirand. And we get a punch thrown. That has to be an ejection. There's no way that player is allowed to stay in the game. Couldn't quite catch the number of the Plymouth player, but I believe it was Admirand get punched in the head and go down. Seems to be all right, Admirand walking off the field just fine. So we'll wait on the penalty announcement to see who that was on the Plymouth side. So the frustration really building for Plymouth State. Can sense it there, the desperation to keep their season alive. And now I do not know the details of what qualifies as an ejection or does not in the rule book. But I can't imagine that that does not meet the criteria. So we will see the referee talking to the scorers table right now. We'll get that radioed over to us in just a moment.
I was fixing something.
So we will wait and see what the call is here, what the final ruling is from the referees. Spending quite a while talking to the scorers table, getting all the details right. Referee's going over and talking to the coaches now. And we'll give you an update as soon as we get the details of what happened. In the meantime, the referee's going over and talking to the defensive core for the Panthers. Porter and his defenders standing around getting an explanation on what happened. Okay, so there's the final call. That's why it took so long. There are actually penalties on both sides. So it was an unnecessary roughness call on Admirand, which instigated the fight. And then Mitchell Prive on the Plymouth State side for fighting and ejected from the game. So a 3-minute penalty, which is as long as you will see, given to Prive. 2-minute penalty given to Admirand. So, we will have both teams down a man for a bit, and then UMB will have a man advantage later.
Their goalie has it.
It's an interesting system of having simultaneous penalties, very different from what you'd see in hockey or other sports that have similar mechanics, something like rugby. And now you have the goalie playing offense just like he's done all day. Looks like we'll get a timeout here. So we'll take a quick break. I think both teams looking to talk over what just happened. Everyone needs to calm down just a little bit, and we'll be back in just a moment. And we are back to the action, and right away we have another flag thrown within about 5 seconds. So we'll see who the call goes against, but it'll be another man in the sin bin for UMB. 3:35 to go, and this chaos potentially, despite it leading to an ejection for one of the starters from Plymouth State, could actually be their opportunity to get back into this game. Of course, without any of the fouls going specifically against Jack Dobrzynski, It is hard to imagine that their face-off struggles will end. But at least with this man advantage, maybe they're able to get one back on the board, get things a little bit closer. And they are able to do just that as a goal goes in and makes it 11-7. So 15 seconds or so into the power play, and it is converted by Plymouth State. They bring it back to a four-goal game. It's their first goal of the half. It's taking them 11 and a half minutes to get on the scoreboard here. So the penalty went against Nick Matizak for the Beacons. Matizak, a sophomore defender. And the stats initially put that in as a goal for the Beacons. That is not correct. So I'll let you know who scored that goal as soon as it's updated. But that did go the way of Plymouth State, of course. Score 11-7 now, and Plymouth State with the ball back. A chance to make this a close game again. I feel like three goals going into the fourth quarter certainly seems doable for the Panthers. They have not had a run like that where they're able to score four or five goals in a row. But if they can just get two or three in a row to end this period within one or two, certainly things look a lot better for them than they did a few minutes ago. A shot to the near side, good defense, and Meinhold was never going to give him that near corner, so that shot had to go across the goal, and it was just too hard to get the ball over there with that much defensive pressure. So good defense, good goalkeeping, 2:22 to go in the third quarter. Beacons going back quickly the other way, and it's Sprague who drives it in with the long stick. Huge goal from Robert Sprague. And it was Nick Drew who got that last goal for Plymouth State. And now Sprague, his first of the day. And first of the season, actually, for Robert Sprague. Listed as a midfielder, generally on the more defensive side of the ball, but has contributed quite a bit to the offensive end. Now finally able to get one on the scoreboard in a huge situation. Right as it seemed like Plymouth State might be getting some of their momentum back, immediately brings the lead right back up to five goals. And almost a face-off win for Plymouth State. Can they win the scramble for it? Still cannot. Dobrzynski picks it up. Loose ball going to be claimed by number 17, Patrick Colburn. And that was closer, but yet again, it is Dobrzynski coming out on top in the face-off circle, or in the face-off square, rather, as well as well out of it.
That was such a good shot, though.
And that shot's going to be deflected, taken away. Panthers increasing the pace a little bit, finally, with a minute 40 to go in the third quarter. They trail by five, and that sense of urgency does seem to be hitting them now. Remember, they also lost Mitchell Prive, the junior, who had been a key part of their midfield this whole game. He was ejected from the game for fighting. Was apparently provoked by Admirand, who got 2 minutes in the sin bin, and then Prive was given 3 minutes and ejected. It looks like the penalties are all over now. We're back to full strength lacrosse here. So each team with 10 players on the field once again. The score at 12-7 with a minute to go in the third quarter. Beacons lead it by as much as they've led all day. And that pass goes a little bit too high. It looks like it was deflected, so it will not be a turnover as Panthers win the race. So 12 to shoot, 34 to go in the period. And a shot ripped from the point. Going to be blocked, deflected back to the person who shot it. But the shot clock will go off. And with just 19 seconds to go, the Beacons will take possession back. Maybe one more quick chance. Fahey dropped it initially. Good defensive pressure, but he's able to maintain possession. 8 seconds to go. Plymouth State with it. Maybe one final shot here. 3 to shoot. There's the shot. It's knocked away by Meinhold, and that'll do it. So, a very intense third quarter. After a relatively slow-paced and relaxed first two quarters, tensions rise, penalty flags fly, and the goals finally start coming in for the Beacons as they outscore them 4-1 in that period. The defense really solidifying for UMass Boston in that third quarter. And we'll take a quick break and come back for the final 15 minutes of this game in just a moment. Hello, everyone, and welcome back to James Cotter Field for the final quarter of regulation between UMass Boston and Plymouth State. Here in the semifinals of the Little East Conference playoffs of men's lacrosse, UMass comes in at number one, Plymouth at number five, had to upset number four EastCon to get here. And at the moment, it looks like their run will end here, but the game is certainly not over yet. We've got 15 more minutes to play, and they finally win a faceoff. Had to delay that a little bit. But that is a faceoff win for Plymouth State, and that is huge. That has been their biggest weakness all day. Before that one, Dobrzynski was over 90% on faceoffs today for the Beacons. So if they can start to get just a few of those, maybe they're able to get rolling and get back into this game. An update from the other semifinal that's going on, WestCon and Keene State. WestCon up 10-4 through three quarters there. Keene State's offense just not able to get anything going today at all. So, barring a massive comeback from Keene, the winner of this will play WestCon. UMB would host. If Plymouth State comes back, they would be the visitors. Some good passing here for the Beacons, and a shot!
Oh, I thought that made it in.
Looked like it went in, but that one did go wide. Might have deflected off the side netting. We've seen that a couple times. And a low shot. Good save once again by Porter. And I mentioned earlier today, but I just can't say enough that Porter has done everything he possibly can to keep this team alive today. Incredible play from the goalkeeper from Plymouth State, but it is going to be tough for them to keep this game close if they're not able to get more face-off wins and more offensive pressure. As I say that, a penalty flag does fly as a delayed penalty call going against UMB. So looking for a chance here, and if they lose the ball, they'll get another chance. Ball knocked loose, UMB will pick it up, and that'll start the penalty. So just about 2 minutes played here in the fourth. And looks like it might be Lenfest going to the box. We'll confirm that in a moment, but looks like it's Conor Lenfest over there. In the cinnamon for now. So 2 minutes played in the fourth quarter. And it is Lenfest for offsides. So an extra man situation here. Plymouth State comes into this 13-for-60 on the season, 22-ish percent. Which is not exactly what you're looking for. A little bit on the lower end. UMB for reference, right around 26%. Another flag flies. Delayed penalty. Once again going against Plymouth State. And I'll turn over, so we'll get the penalty started here. And we'll get the penalty call. Going the other way this time. Lenfest's penalty has expired, so this will be man up for the Beacons now. And this time offside on Liam Brown. So Brown will go to the penalty box for a bit, the freshman midfielder. And the Beacons will go another power play opportunity. Power plays have not turned out super well for either team so far. Neither team has been able to convert much off of them. The Beacons getting just one goal. And a good takeaway once again. So the man down defense from both teams has been solid. That keeps up here, and maybe an opportunity in transition. A lot of open space, one-on-one with the goalie. And what a stop by Meinhold, getting his leg in front of that to deflect it wide. So I've talked about how good Robert Porter has been. Christian Meinhold has certainly also been dominant in goal today for the Beacons. And has made this Plymouth State team work so hard to get anything by him. They were able to get a little bit going in the first and second quarters. Three goals in each of those. But just one in the entire second half so far. That is 18 and a half minutes of gameplay. A lot of quick movement around the net here. Out to Donnelly. Donnelly shoots. He scores. Donnelly with a beautiful skip shot. Bouncing under the right leg of Meinhold. And it's back to a four-goal game. So we've played about 4 minutes in this fourth quarter. Score is now 12-8. And no matter what, Plymouth State putting up way more of a fight than they did last time these two teams played has certainly been a respectable performance from them today. So here we are with 11 minutes to go in regulation. And Plymouth State, not done yet. Dobrzynski will actually not win another faceoff. It's a loose ball. It'll eventually be claimed by Plymouth. And they lose it right back to the Beacons anyway. So a delayed faceoff win for UMB, but a win nonetheless. I'll look at their offensive unit set up. And finally now with a lead in the fourth quarter, they have started to slow down the pace a little bit on the offensive end. Still not too much, and if they see a good chance for a shot early in the shot clock, they will still take it just like that, and it goes in right on cue. The Beacons get another one on the board.
Eight.
And that is going to be Admirand for the, I believe, fourth time today. I'll double check on that here. So, a huge save by Meinhold on the other end. Kept this game at 12-8. And then a face-off win leads to another goal. Admirand puts it by for, as I mentioned, the fourth time. So most of the goals today from Admirand and Przinski. Seven goals between the two of them. And then five assists for Conor Lenfest. And that's where we've seen most of the offense come from. We've certainly seen a lot of involvement from Fahey and Zach Mann as well. And then the goal from Robert Sprague, of course, which sort of stopped any momentum that Plymouth State may have had at the end of the third. So the lead's back to five. Plymouth State, really important possession here. With 10 minutes to go, if they score here, this is still back and forth game, as that one will go just wide, and they'll keep possession. If they give the ball away here and give up a goal, 14-8 does seem pretty much like the game is probably over. But 13-9, on the other hand, would not feel like that to me, at least. And we'll see if they're able to get this back within four goals again, as that's a dropped pass. And that's huge. The Beacons take the ball away. Every possession matters so much at this point in the game. Let's see if the defense can stay strong and force a turnover here quickly. Beacons have plenty of time to shoot if they want to run the clock down, but you know they're looking for the dagger instead. Lenfest, back to the point, dropped initially, but maintained by Murphy. Good passing as usual from UMass Boston. Murphy finds some space, now just goes behind the net again. And that race will go to the Beacons, actually. On a missed shot. 32 to shoot still. Fake shot. Now a real shot, and that one goes. The Beacons are up by 6, their biggest lead of the night. And it is Admirand once again putting in what is likely the goal that will ice this one for UMass Boston. 8:45 to play. 6 goals in 8:45 is not impossible, but it is incredibly difficult when you are facing someone who is 21 of 25 in the faceoff circle. So, Dobrzynski trying to grab this one. The Beacons will actually not get this one cleanly. Still a scramble for it. And that is going to be a foul called against Plymouth State. Faceoffs can get a little physical. And that is legal to some degree. If somebody gets knocked down like that, possession will probably be awarded the other way. Not a penalty that will lead to a man advantage, just a penalty that leads to possession. So the Beacons get the ball once again. Another faceoff win. Sitting at a 14-8 lead right now. 8 minutes and 15 seconds to go in regulation. The Beacons passing has looked very solid, especially after the first quarter. We saw some errant passes go out of the way in the first. Since then, they've been very good. That was a good takeaway by the defense of Plymouth State. But the Beacons knock it loose once again right on the other side of the field. So we're at 7:45 remaining in regulation, and the Beacons can feel that chance in the finals now. Quick shot goes just wide. And Porter actually wins the race. Very heads-up play from Robert Porter right there. So, to the bitter end, Porter has been spectacular and stays very aware of his surroundings at all times. Not just being a good shot stopper, but really playing every aspect of the game so far. And he kept his team in it for a long time, but it is starting to slip away now. 14-8 is the lead for UMass Boston. And 6 goals in now just over 7 minutes is seeming less and less likely for a team who only has 2 goals so far this half. Shot comes in. Deflected wide in front. Couldn't see if that was off Meinholt or a defender, but it'll go wide and it'll be taken still by the Panthers. 7 minutes exactly to go now. Errant pass gets out of bounds and the Beacons take possession. So, UMass Boston will get the ball back. And if they can start to just run a minute off the clock every time they have the ball now, it doesn't even matter if they score. They will win the game if they can just win a couple of faceoffs and avoid turnovers. So, definitely a situation where you can start playing to the clock and then see if you can catch anyone being a little too lax on the defensive side expecting you to play to the clock or being too aggressive and giving you free shot opportunities. For now, the Beacons will keep passing the ball around. Really good ball movement throughout this fourth quarter as a quick shot goes over the shoulder of Porter. Przinski gets his 4th. And they've almost doubled up Plymouth State at this point. 15-8 with 6.5 to go. So feeling more and more like this game is just about over. As UMB had to struggle through the first half as we'll get a quick timeout called here. But they have come roaring back in the second half. Absolutely dominated so far in these third and fourth quarters. We'll take a quick break for this timeout, and we'll be back with you for the conclusion of this game in just a moment. Welcome back, everyone. We are here for the final 6.5 minutes of this semifinal game between UMass Boston and Plymouth State in men's lacrosse. Winner of this likely to go on to play WestCon, but Keene State has brought it back a little bit. We checked the score during that break. Keene State has brought it back from 10-4 to 11-7. And immediately another goal from UMass Boston. They have doubled up the Panthers now. And it was Admirand again. So when they had their back up against the wall just a little bit in a really tight game with a team they expected to beat, it is Gavin Admirand who has pulled away completely and made this game look like far more of a blowout than it felt like for the first 2.5 quarters. And that was so quick off the faceoff that Dobrzynski actually got the assist. Dobrzynski wins the draw, runs at the field, got shoved to the ground that time. They're going to call that one legal, though. Fans don't like it. We have fans, by the way. First time we've had fans allowed in the stadium here. So, small crowd, socially distanced, mostly with masks on. We are also outdoors here. But great to see some fans again, hear the energy in the stadium for the first time in a while. And quick wraparound opportunity will not go as Porter's going to sprint over there and get the ground ball before anyone can stop him. And Porter, tired of not getting enough help, says, I'll do this myself. And then decides against him when he gets double teamed. But really nothing but good things to say about Robert Porter today. He's had a spectacular game. The rest of the team has just not been able to keep up on offense with the pace of UMass Boston. As Beacon's offense, I mentioned the big three at the start of this game. Really, most of their points come from Admirand, Lenfest, and Fahey. Przinski has really joined with them today, and those four have been dominant as a unit, scoring the vast majority of the goals, mostly coming from the other three, and then Lenfest assisting most of them. And no one's been able to step up and be that leader that was necessary today on the other side for the Panthers. And Donnelly has done his best. He's had some really good passes, some really good runs, finding some holes in the defense, cutting through some open space. But it has just not been enough to keep this game close. Despite a very close first half, it was 3-3 after one quarter. It was 8-6 at the halftime. But so far, the Beacons have outscored Plymouth State 4-1 in both quarters in the second half. So we get one more timeout, and we will come back with probably the final few minutes of this game right after this. All right, we're back from the timeout here, and already we have a turnover from Plymouth State. So Beacons have pretty much locked this one up. 4:30 remaining in the game. And the only response from Plymouth State has been to get a bit more physical, and it hasn't really gotten them very far other than one or two trips to the penalty box. So a full minute still on the shot clock. Beacons can run this down to about 3.5 to go if they would like. The way they've played this fourth quarter, they also might just shoot at any point in time and try to expand this lead even more. They only had like 6 players on the field for a moment there. Now everyone comes back out.
There's just no offense.
Lenfest rifles one down low. A great save once again. That one deflects away out of bounds off of Porter. Przinski, dangerous pass down low. Not quite going to work out. That one goes out of bounds. Another turnover going the Beacon's way. Now can they expand this lead even farther? Doesn't really make too much of a difference at this point. Long pass over here to the near side. Ambitious. Attempting to get the ball here on the near side to Declan Alexander, but he's not going to be able to come down with it as the pass was probably 10 feet over his head. So Beacon's possession once again at a new shot clock, under 3 minutes to go. That is all that separates UMass Boston from a spot in the finals, which will be played here, assuming they do hold on Saturday. And there is another goal for UMass Boston. They get up to 17 on the day.
That one was Lenfest.
And that one will be second in the day for Conor Lenfest. So more than double the score now, and the second half has just been completely one-sided after a very tight first half. So Conor Lenfest comes into this game second on the team in goals with 26, and he will get his second today. Oh, and his score has gone to 11-9 over on the other semifinal. WestCon still keeping their lead, but only by two over Keene State with 5 minutes left. So potential for a huge comeback over there for Keene. We'll keep you updated on that. Might take longer than our game since they're having a much higher scoring fourth quarter. But barring one of the strangest comebacks we would ever see, the winner of that game will be coming here on Saturday. So it'll be broadcast right here on Saturday. And the Beacons beat WestCon earlier this season, but it was a very close game. Second closest game of the season, in fact. They won 19-15. They didn't play Keene State. The game got canceled due to COVID. And it looked like Keene was a bit out of it in the early going in their game. They trailed 10-4 after three quarters. As that will be a consolation goal going over to Plymouth State. They'll get one more on the board and make it 17-9. But what we expect here is that the Beacons will close this one out. It'll be their eighth win in eight games on the season. And they'll play the winner of that game, still going on, WestCon and Keene State. And we are under 2 minutes to go in this one. Panthers do win a faceoff here, but they got to score real fast to make this even look a little bit closer. At this point, he's trying to get that one more to get into double digits, I suppose. So still that sort of slow-paced perimeter offense that we've seen. A dropped pass as they try to get inside, but Plymouth will keep the ball. And that one goes out of bounds. Minute 10 to go. Beacons can feel it at this point. Game pretty much finished for all intents and purposes. Just waiting to see what the final score will be. If anyone will be able to add on to what they've got right now. Currently sitting at 17-9 UMass Boston as we hit under the minute mark now. Plymouth looking for a way through, a dropped ball, still loose, scramble for it, still three players on each side, and it is the Beacons who come out with it. Sam James going to get there. Beacons looking for one more, maybe. 26 seconds to go. And the clock will stop with 20 as the whistle is blown. Clock running now. That was a shot that was deflected away. Beacons keep possession. And right at the final moments, players still hustling, trying to win these races, get more possessions. But that should just about do it. When this clock restarts here, the Beacons don't need to do anything else. Pass goes away.
Really glad they
Clock will stop. We're technically not done yet. But as soon as we reset here, that'll be it. So UMass Boston claims this one. Final score, as soon as we restart here, final score is 17-9, and that will do it. The UMass Boston Beacons are moving on to the finals of the Little East Conference. They will play on Saturday against the winner of WestCon and Keene State, a game that is just about to finish, but we don't have a clear winner yet. We're sitting at 2:43 to go over there at Keene. And Keene also did not lose a game this year. They come in at 5-0. WestCon 5-2 overall. So we're not going to be here long enough to tell you how that one finishes, but that game is almost done over there. So the winner will play here on Saturday. Congratulations to the Beacons. 8-0 this season overall, 6-0 within the conference. And they're moving on to the finals as they will look for an undefeated championship season. Thank you all for tuning in with us today here. It's been a great game. And Plymouth State kept it real close for a long time, but the Beacons just too strong, too deep, able to pull away in that second half and not look back. So good stuff to the Plymouth State Panthers on a good season. Semifinal finish.